Today I'm going to show you my version of beef enchiladas. First, we're going to remove the stems, seeds, and the vines from 6 to 8 chile guajillos. I'm also going to add a few chiles de arbol to add a little bit of spice. These are optional. These I'm only going to remove the stems. Heat up 3 to 4 cups of water in a medium saucepan, add the peppers, and cover for about 15 to 20 minutes. Meanwhile, we're going to dice the vegetables for the meat. I'm going to use 2 jalapeños, or you can substitute these for green bell peppers. We also need 1/4 of an onion and 2 garlic cloves. In a medium pan over medium-high heat, brown 1 pound of lean ground beef. Once it looks like this, remove some of the excess fat before adding the onion, garlic, and the jalapeños. Mix in the vegetables, then add 1 teaspoon of cumin, 1/2 teaspoon of oregano, salt, pepper, and 1 tablespoon of chili powder. Mix in the seasonings with the rest of the ingredients, and lastly, we're going to add 1 8-ounce can of tomato sauce. Mix in the tomato sauce and simmer over medium heat for about 5 to 7 minutes with frequent movement or until most of the tomato sauce has simmered down. Remove it from the burner and cover it while we prepare the enchilada sauce. Transfer the peppers to the blender along with 1 to 2 garlic cloves and 3 cups of chicken broth. Blend on high for a good minute or until your sauce is nice and smooth. Heat up a small amount of vegetable oil over medium heat and strain in the sauce. Once all the sauce has gone through the strainer, discard of the residue and season with 1/4 teaspoon of cumin, 1/2 teaspoon of oregano, and 1 tablespoon of chicken bouillon or salt to your liking. Mix in the seasonings and simmer over low-medium heat for about 8 to 10 minutes. For a thicker sauce, dilute 1/2 tablespoon of flour in a little bit of water before adding it to the sauce. Before preparing the enchiladas, lightly fry your tortillas on both sides until they're nice and pliable. Frying the tortillas first is going to help your enchiladas from falling apart once you add the sauce. Add a spoonful of the beef to the bottom of the baking dish and a couple spoonfuls of the enchilada sauce. Prepare the enchilada by adding a spoonful of the meat right in the middle of the tortilla, add los altos queso manchego, roll it up and place it in the baking dish with the flap down. Drown them with the enchilada sauce and top them off with lots of los altos queso manchego. Bake at 350 degrees for 10 to 12 minutes or until the cheese is nice and melted. Top them off with cilantro, tomato, red onion, queso cotija enchilado, and to take it to the next level, drizzle with los altos jocoque. And enjoy!